Hi, my name is John Bradbury and welcome to John's Metal Detecting Adventures. I'm with my brother and we're out in the middle of some beautiful countryside searching for history on a footpath. What machine have you got, Ken?
DS2.
Brilliant. So hopefully with a bit of luck, Ken.
Oh wait, we're not get some silver.
That's it, and then you'll be
no
happy.
No silver yet, we're quite happy for getting one at least.
Right, okay. Hopefully, let's find some silver. Detecting, he's trying. Pottery, some sort of dish, I think it's around about 1960s, middle of the 20th century really, bit of pottery. Common wear, I think spectacular. 73, yeah, we got one.
Right, on a George V penny. So I don't know what the date is. That's Britannia. Now you can see the head.
There we go, George V penny. Very good. George V penny, fairly good. What have we got there then, Ken?
Got a signal here.
What number is it?
So we'll find
what number
out.
Is it, Ken?
92
on the dais. Come on then. That's a good number, that, Ken. That could be silver.
Oh, it's there, look. It's copper.
Oh, it's copper.
Yeah, look, you see it.
It's a coin, is it?
Yeah, I can see it there.
Yeah. Half penny, is it?
Ooh. That's a bit old.
That looks like bloody Roman, that, Ken. Yeah, 70, oh, 69, 71, 70. Buckle. 19th to 20th century. That was quite deep, actually. Down there. Very deep. 87. Yeah, I can see it. It's a big coin of somebody. It's a 10p of Elizabeth II. That's what that is.
Eighty-six
buckle. Oh yeah, sort of 19th, 20th century. Jolly good, very good.
And we found an old pound coin. So obviously it's the second. Been here a bit though.
55. There we go, George V penny. Very good, George V penny, fairly good. 1917, smack in the middle of the First World War.
We're on the total count up. It's evening. It's time to chill out. So, what do you reckon then, Ken?
Oh, we had a few coins, haven't we? No silver, though.
Shame, isn't it? I think someone else has done it. What do you think?
I've heard someone been on it before, like, but I don't know. There's still a chance yet to get something else.
Yeah.
Big massive field, there's more been in two or three fields here.
Yeah, so this is a footpath that goes in different direction, isn't there?
Yeah, there's a few footpaths crossing over in this one. And the same with that one over there.
Just in the nick in the wall is the footpath. So it comes up this way and that way, and we've done all this all afternoon. So far, here we go. Not a lot. Some sort of copper buckle, some sort of chain thing, I don't know what that is. Small buckle there. Some sort of fancy piece of brass. And some buttons. 17th century, 18th century buttons. And then you've got the coins, which are Edward the VII. We've got George the V. I think it's George the III, half penny. 10p of our late Queen, I think. Elizabeth the II on that. Victoria penny, half penny. Victoria penny. Is this another George? That's another Edward. Yeah, another Edward the seventh. That'll be another George the III. Another George the V. And 2p. So that's all I've got. So let's look at Car Ken's.
10 lemon coins.
Similar type of thing, George the V, George the V, George the III. Now that's Victoria with the mourning veil. So that'll be something in between 1893 to 1901. You've got another Victorian penny's a bit worn, and couple of George V pennies, so that'd be 1920, 17, maybe possibly some of them might be First World War.
1927 and
1929. Oh, right, okay. 1929, significant date, which is the stock market crash, and that's where a lot of people lost a lot of money. Got a pound coin there, that's to be cashed up, and 20p. And then I think you've got a buckle there, haven't you?
Yeah.
Buckle, 19th, 20th century. And I think that's part of a penknife handle, I think, or something. So that's what I can got. A bit disappointing, no silver, I can.
Yeah, but no silver. I'm a bit surprised, really, because it's not really been done that much here, has it?
I don't know. I think to find these amount of coins is not a lot. We thank you very much for watching, and catch you on the next adventure.